All right, guys, welcome to a brand new YouTube video. To start this video off, I am going to show you guys a quick mini grocery haul. These are going to be the foods that I'm going to be cooking for this week. As you guys know, I am currently almost 5 weeks out. This Saturday, I'll be 5 weeks out from the Corrupted Strength Classic that will be happening November 14th. And I wanted to start dialing in a little bit more nutrition-wise. I mean, I'm obviously dialing in training-wise, but I wanted to mimic that with my nutrition as well, kind of to give myself the feeling of actually prepping for meat. So these are gonna be the foods I'm gonna be eating for the next 6 weeks. Obviously, it's not everything that I'm gonna be eating, but these are gonna be most of the foods going forward, just ingredient-wise. So what we have here is jasmine rice, which is a staple of my nutrition. We have mushrooms, ground turkey. We have some egg whites over there in the back. We also have some chicken that I'm gonna be cooking. So I also alternate through just cooking these seasoned chicken breasts. So it's a lot easier to cook, but sometimes I also buy the raw chicken breasts as well. We have some cherries to put in the Greek yogurt, which I use for snacks. Parsley, teriyaki, or spicy teriyaki sauce. And then I'm gonna show you guys some of the stuff that I will be eating as well that I didn't buy. So right here we have some Quaker Oats maple and brown sugar oatmeal. What else? We also have some nuts over here. What else? I think this is the only thing I wanted to show you guys. Obviously, I'll be adding in some of the Kodiak protein power cakes, but I think that's pretty much it for the most part. Let me see my fridge, see if there's anything I want to add. All I see my fridge is like there's nothing in here, but I think that's pretty much it. So that's gonna be it nutrition wise I'm gonna go ahead and start cooking my post-workout meal. I have not eaten whatsoever. The only thing that I've had so far is a protein shake that was post-workout, but I need a post-workout meal, like a legitimate meal with substance. So what we're gonna be making here is the ground turkey. We're making the ground turkey with mushrooms, the zucchinis that I did not mention, and that should be pretty good, along with the jasmine rice, obviously. So that will be my post-workout meal. And yeah, I'm hungry as hell, so let's go ahead and make this. Boom, and now we got the finished product here. Hopefully it's not too fogged up, but what we have is the ground turkey, zucchini. I think the other one, I think they're both zucchini. Oh, zucchini and squash, there we go. Zucchini, squash, parsley, jasmine rice, mushrooms with a little bit of spicy teriyaki sauce poured up on there, but this is about like 55, 60 grams of protein. I wanna say 100 grams of carbs, and yeah, just gonna go ahead and eat this, super hungry. But yeah, so we're getting back to the basics, man. Anyone that's been following my channel for quite some time knows that this is OG. This is like a staple of my diet whenever I start counting macros and kind of zoning in for meat or trying to lose some weight. This is like one of the best post-workout meals out there. So go ahead and sit down, grub, and enjoy this meal. About that check, boy. Came a long way from that Woodlawn Park. Now young man, they push to start. Okay, what's up, guys? Welcome to Tuesday's portion of the vlog. So yesterday, I kind of gave you guys an insight as to some of the ingredients or some of the groceries that I will be utilizing for this cut for the next 6 to 5 weeks leading up to my meat. So I wanted to give you guys further insight into my eating habits whenever I am on point, quote unquote, with like my diet and just like nutrition and all that kind of stuff, and how I personally like to lose weight. Everyone has their own method in which they choose to, you know, lose weight. So I wanted to go through what I normally do. It is 8:15 a.m. I have not eaten a single calorie and we're about to train. And that's how I prefer to do things. So we'd like to call this intermittent fasting. Now, I normally do not start eating until I actually get back home, which is around 2 to 3, maybe even 4. And my eating window is from 4 to 9 p.m. So I have 5 hours to kind of eat. But the benefits of that is that with a small feeding window or eating window, I always feel full. I go to sleep actually very uncomfortable because of how full I am. Not very uncomfortable. I go to sleep like fulfilled. A lot of times whenever you're dieting, you have to battle that feeling of just like extreme hunger. But when I do intermittent fasting, it allows me to kind of defeat that feeling. Not everyone's built for it. But the way I kind of skate around that, right? So it's 8:15 in the morning right now. I'm about to work out. So what I'm going to do
is take pre-workout. So the caffeine is gonna kind of suppress my hunger and kind of keep me just focus on the workout at hand, and I'm not focused on my hunger. So once I finish on my workout, it's like, what, maybe 10, 11-ish, I get work done all the way up until 2 to 3, I drive home, and then I eat. So, we're about to take, I don't call this a meal. So this is gonna be the first calories that, that enters my body. It's 80 total calories. It's 22 grams of carbs, but I don't really count it because it's like a liquid. It's not actual food. Same thing with my protein shake. Yes, technically it is a quote unquote meal or snack, but it's not like actual solid food that's gonna take up real estate in my stomach, if that makes sense. So anyways, let me drink this, mix it with the pre-workout, and get to actually lifting. So a little caveat or a little thing I wanna add in is that I normally don't work out this early. I usually work out around 10 to 11, that sweet time. So then when I work out 10 to 11, I'm still fasted. Then we get to that 2 to 3 p.m. mark, then that's when I finish up my work, and then I get back to the crib. But today's a little bit different just because I want to just come in and work out. I've been waking up super early, and the first thing I want to do when I wake up is work out, because I know I don't feel comfortable coming into the gym with food in my stomach. So what's gonna happen is that when I wake up, I'm like, bro, I wanna get this workout out of the way so I can enjoy food. And the longer I wait, the tougher it is for me to get an efficient workout out of it. Hey, yo.
Rocky Calabashes, out of Calabashes, tucked in Mackey, off-white fatigue with the army patches, a long savory suede sweatsuit, poor major star spangle, Draco blew his head off from all angles, Alchemist cool hoodies boom, sipping Vove, my little nigga dropped out the first day of school, dropped tears when I broke my
today's, I don't know if I explained today's workout, but we were supposed to hit a single at RP of 67, and that ended up being 622 pounds. It's funny because last Saturday, I hit 600 pounds for a very, very easy set of five. So I think what's happening is, not what's happening, but my Saturdays feel really, really, really good. So I feel like this upcoming Saturday, I have a 5x4. I think I might knock out like six. I'll probably do something close to this weight for my first set of four, which is like funny. But okay, now we have sets of six. Judging by how that 622 moved, we gotta be a little bit more humble on the weight today. I think 496 or five, what's the number, 506 or something like that would be okay for my sets, or it's 507, will be good for my sets of six at RPA 7, so. Woo! I did all of this, fasted too. You know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to give you guys an insight of like how I normally train and how I eat when I'm training leading up to a competition. So, fasted, single, out of the way. I feel way better training fasted. I've tried for so many years to incorporate food before I lift, and it feels horrible. Like, I get gassy, I start feeling awkward, like I'd be farting. I don't like that shit, man. No pun intended. Like, farting leading up to a set is so gross to me, and I won't push against my belt because I don't want to fart on camera. I don't know. Maybe that's too much information, but.
Thank you.
we finished up with the workout. It's funny because we were taking pictures for IG and thumbnails, and I was making a joke about how it's like does one day of dieting. But like, it's funny how much water your body holds when you have a lot of, you're eating shit that has a lot of sodium and salt. So it's just funny because like, I did not look like this yesterday. Like, I'm a lot more, not lean, but you can tell like the water weight is just kind of coming off a little bit. So like once I drop like a solid, once I drop like a solid 5 pounds, like I'm gonna look really, really lean. And then like when I start like upping on my carbs and filling out, it's gonna look even crazier. So just funny how, it's not funny, but nutrition plays a huge role in number one, how you look and how you feel whenever you're training. Before we even hopped on, started filming, I was telling Duhan, it's like, it's funny how different you feel when you're not eating like shit. Cause like, what would happen is I would go home after training and eat some bullshit and feel just like fucking horrible. Like I just feel like so full and just like, just fat. And I just feel like the food just sitting there. I'm just like, ugh. But then last night when I ate, I felt so clean. Like it's just funny. I just felt like, it just felt very, very clean. I ate, I was full, but I wasn't like disgusting, if that makes sense. But I'm only discussing these things because I know there's a lot of people that watch my channel that don't utilize these simple things that go into training and getting better and improving your body composition. So I'm just discussing every little thing that I feel whenever I'm on point. So, okay, we're done with today's workout. I'm gonna focus on number one, now recovery. So what I'm about to go in there right now is get a scoop of protein and my strong greens and mix that into a post-workout shake. And then I probably won't eat again until, what time is it right now? I probably won't eat again until like maybe 2 or 3-ish. So it is what it is. I'm gonna head on over to Alphalete, get a workout and then take the post-workout shake. Sorry, that was confusing. Okay guys, we are part two of our workout. Juwan went to go get a workout in, or not a workout, he went to go get a haircut. So right now we're about to get this leg workout in solo. As you guys know, I don't work out legs, but I decided that today being 5 to 6 weeks out, we're gonna work out legs. Damn, this mask keeps falling down, but we're gonna work out legs. So I'm not gonna talk too much. I'm just gonna kind of roll through it and just work.
I'm actually having to talk to you guys via voiceover because all the footage got deleted, or not the footage, but the voice, the sound was not picking up. So I just wanted to kind of detail what we're going through right now. So as you guys are watching this, you guys are watching me eat my first meal of the day, which is 2 servings of the Kodiak pancake mix with the, I think it's a cup or two of egg whites. So right now I'm discussing the fact that I put cookie butter on top of my Kodiak pancake. I'm not a fan of peanut butter. I usually go with cookie butter. The reason why I go with cookie butter is because I need to add more fat into my diet. It's kind of tough to get fat in my diet with the foods that I like to eat. So the cookie butter helps does that, do that, and also adds a couple of extra grams of carbs. So after I add the cookie butter, I'm pretty sure I discussed with you guys the fact that I put parsley on damn near everything. So you see the eggs right there that have sriracha on top, but I also throw the parsley there. So that's my first meal of the day, I believe coming around like 2 to 3 to 4 p.m. somewhere along that window.
And then after we discuss breakfast, we move on to my staple, which is ground turkey, rice, and vegetables, which I started throwing parsley on as well. So as you guys can see, I don't really like to eat breakfast. I usually like to train first and then eat breakfast after. It shortens my eating window and allows me to kind of get that full sensation whenever I go to sleep at night. Anyways, I think that's pretty much everything that I wanted to say in this voiceover. So I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the video, and I'll talk to you shortly.
I got blood on my hands, I ain't gon' lie, I got mud on my shoes, I ain't gon' lie, I got real.
What's up, guys? What's happening? It has been a full day since I last been recorded. So Tuesday, I recorded, pretty sure I recorded some of my meals, if not just breakfast, and then I went to go do my workout. Monday, I showed you guys kind of like what I was going to start eating. But now it's Thursday, we're about to get to business. It is a little bit later inside of the day. It's like getting close to 5 o'clock, and what we're going to be doing today is live streaming for the first time on Twitch. So we're gonna be live streaming the workout. So if you guys haven't followed me already, the link will be in the description box. But the goal with that is that I want to hop on Twitch for the workouts that I don't record. So situations like yesterday. Yesterday I didn't pick up my camera at all. It would've been cool to hop on real quick on live stream as I was working out, talk to you guys, communicate, and you guys watch what I would do on that particular workout. But I don't think I've mentioned on this channel yet, I've thrown away my deadlift slippers. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know that just deadlifting those deadlift slippers have been absolutely fucking annoying. It just looks stupid. I look like a fucking like ballerina, right? So, was it yesterday or was it Monday that I did that? I think it was Monday, right?
I think it was Monday, yeah.
Monday, I literally like overnighted a shit ton of new, new deadlift shoes. So, what we're going with right now is going to be the wrestling shoes. Those are the ones that provide the best kind of footing for lifting in general. Not only deadlift, but squats as well. So says Joey. I will be seeing that pretty soon, but check this out. I went with Nike. So it's taken me so long to kind of make this switch because I didn't even know that Nike had shoes that were conducive for lifting in general. But so I bought this in like every single colorway. So we have the white camo. We have like the black with the outline, the white outline check. And then we also have, this is gonna be funny. It's literally the same shoe, but whatever. We have the black with the silver check. So just judging by what I'm wearing, I'm trying to see what shirt I'm gonna change into. But if I'm gonna stay with the long sleeve, then I'll just go wear these cause we keep like that ice white type of look. But okay, I'm excited. So we have a heavy single today at RP of 7, meaning we might get around like 672 to 700. At best, which I'm highly doubting, but whatever. Then after that, I think we have like a 3x5 or 4x5 or something along that lines. But we're gonna hop on live stream. We're gonna be fun. All right, so I'll catch you guys when we get to that top single. Okay. Let's fucking roll.
Big bag, big racks, on that same shirt. Broke boys spent this last dollar on that lane, okay. Bitch. Hunting in a Beamer, quit swerving in my lane, bitch. Givenchy on my collar, sipping Henny, I can't stain, bitch. Big bag, big racks, on that same shirt. Broke boys spent this last dollar on that lane, okay. Bitch. Hunting in a Beamer, quit swerving in my lane, bitch. Givenchy on my collar.
Good on camera, right?
Oh, 700.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. So I'm hyped, man. I don't know what it was today, but I don't know how we managed a 700 pull today, but it was there. So this Saturday we're gonna be 5 weeks out from our meet, and 700 moved really, really good 5 weeks out. But right now we're about to drop the weight down. Quick side note: these shoes feel fucking amazing. They feel amazing, and they look dope as hell. Like it feels like I'm wearing cleats. Like I don't know, it feels cool. So I want to share something with you guys, but I'm not gonna get it until probably like another week or so. So I'm not gonna say anything. But like I said, we're gonna do back downs. We have a 4x5 at RP of 6 beltless. So I think that 596 pounds is gonna be the weight that we're gonna be working with. What?
500?
Oh, what did I say, 596?
Yeah.
496, excuse me. So we got beltless work. I'm just gonna keep it really, really light. And build up for Saturday and the next Tuesday and the next Thursday as well, because we have another single at 7. So let's get to work. Hey, we live on Twitch. So say what's up to Twitch. So once again, if you guys want to follow me on Twitch, the link will be in my description box. I'm gonna be doing this more often. It's pretty cool. I think at the peak of this live stream, we had 141 people, which is like cool. I don't know, it feels cool to like have people watch you work out, because it's like another factor that motivates you to lift heavy. Like I was like, everyone get hype, I'm about to do my single, and everyone's like, let's go. I was like, oh shit, let's go. So I had to make it look fast. Dripping off the cows. Alright. Bellows work. 5 reps, 4 sets. We are kind of decorating the office space because it's Halloween. So I don't know if you can see the spooky designs, but I'm about to spend the rest of the day doing this or helping out with this. So, all right, I'll catch you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow we have bench. We're gonna work up to the heavy singer. Then Saturday, let's go on bench. So, all right. Okay, we're going to end today's video. I just wanted to give you guys a couple of gym updates and then also give you some updates regarding GBT. So let's go ahead and move back over here. So for a very, very, very long time, here at the facility, whenever we had Corrupted Saturdays, I wouldn't even say complaints, because it was kind of like an understanding. One of the complaints, or just one of the observations, was the fact that it was very, very hot in here. We are located in Houston, Texas, technically Stafford, Texas, and it is very, very, very hot at all times, right? This gym has no central AC. It's literally just a warehouse space. And once you come in here, it's like, you alone, fight for yourself. So, I think I've told you guys for a very long time that we were going to get fans established here at the facility, and we went with big ass fans. So, these fans are surprisingly very, very effective. And it's really, really cool because it's very simple to operate, and you can control it at all times. So, we turn it on, it's a little bit of lag period, but you turn it on, fan goes, this is at 50%. What we want to accomplish with the fan is that we need air pushing over across the gym out to the garage area, so there's cool always air circulating. So like whenever you're working out here, you can literally just feel it. It feels so good just to have air just kind of pushed onto you. Because when you do work out here, once again, the humidity and the heat alone is just overbearing. So we have one fan on this side, and then we have another fan on the other side. And they're able to still put the banner up behind it, which looks pretty cool. And we're gonna be able to establish another banner here, and then we'll complete this wall. Going all the way over to here, I'm sure you guys can kind of see it now. We're going all the way over to this area. We finally have a sign being put up. So they're literally at Home Depot right now taking care of that. And we're going to be putting this sign all the way up there. I don't know if you guys can see the little metal rod sticking out of the ceiling or sticking out of the wall, but this sign is gonna be going up. This sign is like, I mean, you guys can see it, it's fucking bigger than me. I mean, it's not really saying that much, but it's pretty damn big. It's pretty damn tall. I think it's, I wanna say from the bottom, I wanna say it's like close to 8 feet tall. But yeah, this big ass sign is gonna be up on the wall. It also is backlit, so it has the red LED lights. It's gonna look so cool. Like, it's gonna look really, really cool. So we'll be completing that in the next, I wanna say, hour and a half or so. Also, if you guys did not get an opportunity, the Get Better Today hats are restocked. I packaged all the other ones, but they're restocked right here. So if you guys wanna shop that, I know a lot of you guys missed out on the opportunity to cop it when they first dropped. And people were still hitting me up. They're like, why are they still sold out? I'm like, fam, they're on the website. And then also the Miami Vice t-shirts, the Undeniable t-shirts that have like the cartoon lettering and it says Undeniable since 15. And then also, what's the other shirt that's restocking? Oh, the astronaut tee. I know that one was like super popular and it hasn't been restocked. I think we only launched it once or twice, but it's coming back. So that's pretty much it. I think that's all we got for today's video. It's just fun to see everything kind of come together, and every single day and every single week, we're adding more and more to the facility. So I want to thank you guys so much for tuning into today's video. Like always, if you guys like today's video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Get better today. I'm out.
So hard that I make a hate nigga do the motherfucking dish face. Fly ass nigga handsome, tantrum. G got a little tecker, it's a ransom. Don't play dumb, motherfucker, this the anthem.